again, everyone. So this is the last little video we're going to do for this Lister HRW2 install job. Today, just a couple of tweaks here and there. I've got to turn the pump on the gearbox 180 degrees so that you get the correct direction for the control, so that forward is back and back is, sorry, forward is forward and back is back. Getting muddled up already. Going to pump out some of the water from the cooling tank. I'm going to change that for an equal amount of antifreeze because we didn't put any in, so I want to make sure that the system wasn't leaking anywhere. Stopcocks have all been off on the tank. The engine volumes remain the same. I'll double check the little pipe extension I made. I'm pretty sure it's all good, so we can now withdraw some fluid and put antifreeze in, so that helps preserve the inner workings of the cooling system. I was going to mention about two cooling systems, so it's not particularly the way I wanted to do it, but again, to change this system would have been a bit of an abomination to the engine, so one has to respect things. Well, you don't have to, but I think it's right. So basically what you've got here is this engine would traditionally be water cooled, or raw water cooled in fact, because this is a raw water pump. So these pumps are designed to draw water up from the canal or the sea or whatever it is that you're running through. They're able to create a vacuum, and obviously once you create negative pressure in the line, atmospheric pressure pushes down the water, and then the water will be drawn up into the system, run through, and it will run through the heat exchanger here, and then you would just have an outlet somewhere if you didn't have a wet exhaust. So you could have a wet exhaust system, but it wouldn't be in keeping with this style of boat. Now, we don't have a raw water cooled system. We have a keel cooler, which is hidden behind that panel there. The cold comes down from the corner here and up to the pump, round the system, then the outlet comes out of this bottom corner here and then round the front, around my single piece of pipe, which I'm quite chuffed about. This is the expansion tank, which I'm gonna sort out in a minute for Richard, and then it runs in. So we've got a closed system. Now, the problem we had is because these impeller pumps are quite powerful, you need to be able to purge in the air and be able to fill up the closed side of the tank. You've got heat exchanger, which is means you've got two bodies of water. You've got the keel cooling tank, and then you've got this heat exchanger here. There's a bit of a strange way of doing it, but it's, you know, it, apparently it works, and we are going to test it and see what happens. So it's part of testing today. But yeah, antifreeze will help inhibit any rust, any corrosion, just helps, you know, maintain everything. So, but for now, let me get myself set up, do a little bit of watching on the gearbox. The reason I'm doing this on the pump is because I've put a left-handed prop on this in keeping with the Lister engine. I mean, the gearbox itself is quite modern, so it doesn't really matter what you put on it, but at the moment, when you push forward on the controller, you're getting a stern, I think, and when you're putting back, you're getting a head, so it'd be good to offer that alternative, which is far more intuitive to what one does. So, haven't run the engine today. Richard hasn't run the engine today, so in theory, this shouldn't be too complex, and should be, and hopefully will be, minimal oil loss. So in the manual it says that if you've got twin engine systems, in order to stop the boat always oversteering with two engines running in the same direction, you can have counterworking propellers. And the way you would do that is either have a left-handed running engine, or you simply change the nature of the gearbox and the propeller, and it would dramatically help with the operation of the boat. Otherwise you get all that force in one direction, it doesn't really help. Right, I haven't really thought this through. Right, let's give it a rag down so we put the bolt somewhere. It's a little bit oily. Inevitably there will be some oil drops out of this. It's a nice feature of these boxes actually, that you can do that, being able to just swap a pump around. So as I said in my videos before, if you haven't seen my videos on how these boxes work, I haven't actually covered the 260, but the principle's still the same with all the other hydraulic actuated boxes. So the engine is driving the box through gears mechanically, and it's the hydraulic fluid which is compressing the clutch pack. So changing the pump around is simply changing the direction of flow, which means when you move the lever, it will change the direction of which clutch packs is working and how. So it should be as simple as just do do that, some oil gets dropped out as expected, because this is the pump body. Literally spin it around 180 degrees. If it will fit in there, I don't know if I'm gonna have to take those bolts out of the way. Oh, look at that. I think first let's just have a little clean up, because it's a bit gunky and these O-rings have come out. So double check I'm not making a mistake. So that's 180 degrees round now. A little clean up, get rid of all the oil, that's clean. So that concludes the pump spinning round. We'll test that in a minute and check it all works. Let's have a little bit of a tidy up with the rest of the round. Yeah, it's done that.
Just a quick one. No, yeah. The waft nest just here. Thank you.
Easy. Mm-hmm.